Hey there, it's Rome from the K-pop boy band C-Clown hanging out with you tonight on SBS Pop Asia's K-Wave. And yes, guys, it's that time. It's that time for Rome's Week with Rome. Well, you know, it's called Rome's Week because it's my week. So, you know, of course, it's me, right? It's talking about my week. Don't tell me you guys did not know that, alright? But yeah, Rome's Week. Guys, we finished promotions, for Let's Love. Oh yeah, I mean, it's nothing to be that excited about, but I cannot believe how fast time flies by. And we finished our stage, a couple of days ago. And we did do a special stage, of course, for Molly Molly. And that's a song, called Go Away. I'm pretty sure you guys know what that song is if you're a C-Clown fan, sorry. If you're a C-Clown fan, you know what song I'm talking about right now. But we did end promotions for Let's Love. What do you guys think? Tweet me what you guys thought right now. Yes, as of this moment, and you have to tag SBS Pop Asia and Rome C-Clown in your tweets. So please, I just want to know your honest opinions, because next comeback, it's going to be pretty big, and there's a reason why it's going to be pretty big. I won't spoil you guys right now, but you guys have to keep guessing. La-di-da-di-da. And guys, okay, so it's called Rome's Week, but you know, last week I made you guys a promise about something about singing, and I have no idea why I did that, but I think because you guys are special. Okay, you guys are special. I think I have to sing for you guys. Just to let everyone know out there, to all the new listeners, yes, my name is Rome, and I'm from a boy band called C-Clown. And I'm originally Australian, Korean, multicultural, and I'm proud of it. And I'm a rapper, okay? I rap, and I do a lot of other things but singing. So this is gonna be the first time, yes, actually, it is my first time that I'm ever going to be singing, like, anywhere. This is on radio as well. What am I doing? Okay, so, wow, I can't believe I'm doing this. Okay, so, are you ready? Take a deep breath. Okay, what song should I sing? Or I'll sing a song that I really like, you know, because it's an Australian radio show, so here we go. Alright, before I jump straight into it, this song is actually called Lazy Sunday Morning by Classic Y, and I've never done this, and I'm sorry if I ruined a perfectly good song, but here we go. 1, 2, 3. It's getting late on Sunday morning, I get up and see empty beer bottles rolling around on the bedroom floor. Na 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 na. Okay, I'm sorry, I won't lie, I do not know the rest of the lyrics, but this is just one of the songs I absolutely adore and I love listening to. I apologize if I ruined a completely good song, but it was my first time ever singing ever anywhere, and it's on SBS Pop Asia exclusively. Wow, you guys are so special. And it's worth it, it's worth it. I won't lie, it's worth it. And I hope you guys enjoyed it while it lasted, okay? Because that was quite embarrassing. Oh, gosh. Oh, my goodness. Oh, I can't believe I did that. And, yeah, guys, so what should I do next week? I think this will be a really fun corner because in Rome's Week, I'll tell you guys about my week. But, you know, I think I want to know what you guys want me to do, okay? So I think it's a good idea. So just tweet me what you want me to do next week, and I'll choose like maybe 2 or 3 if I could do 2 or 3, okay? So it's kind of like a request I'm doing for you guys. Wow. How does that sound? I think it sounds absolutely amazing. And yeah, so guys, recently I've been more into the film kind of cinematography kind of thing, and a lot of people been asking me what DPR, the pink reel means, and why I keep using it in all my Instagram videos and etc etc. For those who know, well, that's really good. I'm happy that you guys know. And for those who don't, I'm about to explain. DPR stands for the pink reel, and reason why I named it the pink reel, well, it's going to be a production company that hopefully I'll make official later on. And when I was a kid, I had a dream about watching TV. Like, I don't know, everyone has dreams about weird things, but I had a dream about watching TV, and I was sitting down, and for some reason, you know, the projectors, and they have the film reels inside the projectors, and it kind of keeps rolling, and you can see like the lights shuttering up and down, flickering. And yeah, I was watching the TV through that, okay? So kind of, it was funny because that was reflecting onto a TV and it was projecting images which I cannot remember. But the, all of a sudden, it started like breaking, like the I don't know, the projector just started blowing up, and out came pink smoke out of the projector, out of the reel came out pink smoke. And I don't know why I did this, but I got up and I took out the film reel, like the little long film reels, and I just started stretching it out. I just started taking it out as if I was trying to save some kind of footage of some film, and it was all pink. And then boom, I woke up, and I'll never forget that dream. I don't know, maybe it was like a it was like a meaning from above. But I kind of thought, you know, I couldn't go get this dream to waste. So I decided to name my production thing DPR, the pink reel. And yeah, so that's how the name came about, guys. But yeah, so you know, that was my week, and it was pretty short and brief. But like I said, on Rome's Week, I also want to interact with a lot of my fans and get your opinions and maybe get your requests, what you want me to do, what you want me to say, what kind of things you want me to be doing, like games with like members and stuff. So please, from next week, I think we'll make this corner more fun, more interactive with the fans. So just tweet me up at, you know, Rome_C Clown, or at SBS Pop Asia, or just post on the Pop Asia Facebook page. Send in your requests, because I'll just take all of them and I'll try to do as many as I can, guys. But you know, for now, let's just listen to some more K-pop. And oh, of course, and this is one of my good friend's song. Yes, it's Amber's song. Amber, are you listening to me? Amber, are you hearing this? I'll get Amber on the show. You watch. I'll get Amber on the show. You'll see. And of course, it's FX with Red Light. You're on SBS Pop Asia's K-Wave, and I'm Rome, the leader of K-pop boy band C Clown. If you haven't heard our songs yet, I'll be playing one for you in a while, so do not go away and stay tuned for that. Okay, but for now, it's one of my favorite moments in the show. Yes, 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 it's answering your questions from Facebook and Twitter. Boom, 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 boom. So yeah, I'm going straight to Twitter, and seriously, I cannot thank you guys enough for these messages, because I absolutely adore each one of your messages. I'm sorry if I could not read out your messages, every single one of yours. I will try my best to. But anyway, the first Twitter message is from Rain Joe. Okay, and this person says, as a group, do you have any regrets doing embarrassing things? Not as a group, but I'm kind of embarrassed about me singing, just a moment ago, but, no, but as a group, I think one of the most embarrassing things for us would probably be when, okay, maybe we're on a variety show and we have to show, I guess, the audience, like, Aegyul. Okay, the reason why it's embarrassing as a team is because we have to look at our member doing Aegyul, and we have to put up with that. And it's kind of like, you know, you have a best friend, and you and your best friend go to a meeting, okay? You go for a job meeting, okay? And you're sitting in the same seat, and there's a person who's like testing you for the job. And the guy just goes, okay, so what's the best cute face that you can do to get this job? And this person, and the best friend that you knew for pretty much your whole life, all of a sudden just cracks out this really goosebumpy cute face that you've never seen before and you do not want to see before, and he's been putting that face on for the next 10 seconds, and you just got to watch in fear, like okay, so that's the kind of feeling that we get every time we see our member performing like an Aegyul. Okay, I mean it's cute for the audience, like, to watch it and observe, and it's entertaining, sure, but for us it's kind of like, oh, that's embarrassing, like, Maru, stop it, please. And he's like, I'm like, just don't do that anymore, please. Don't do that anymore. And he just keeps doing it, and it's embarrassing. So thank you. Okay. This next question. Oh wow, this is quite a good question. It's from Quinny Nguyen, and she says, "What were you like back in high school? What do you think I would have been like back in high school? I think back in high school, it brings back a lot of memories. I was the kind of student that studied way up until year 11, and then I just kind of like." Stopped in year 12. I don't know, I think I ran out of steam, okay? The steam that kind of pumped me up for, okay, I gotta do well, I gotta do well in my HSC, you know, in the States they call it SAT, Korea they call it 수능, alright? The big test that everyone's been studying up for. But guys, don't listen to this advice, because I advise you, you have to study well, and seriously, while you can, just do, give it all your best, and you won't regret it, okay? I mean, I kind of regret it because my mom would always try, you know, teaching me stuff, you know, because she's an absolutely smart person. She's a genius. And, you know, I always wanted me being the reckless child. I was like, no, I don't want to study. No, no. And she was like, you have to study, Baron. I'm like, okay. But I always put it off till later. And I'll just be, but instead I would have been dancing. So guys, if you have like another dream or another path, it's good to have like a stable foundation and then go for that dream. Yeah, but you know, okay, yeah, that was me back in high school. I wasn't a very bad boy, okay, but I was a very good boy. Yeah, but anyway, let's go to Facebook, and this one is from Dorian Winchester. Ooh, that's a nice name. Batman or Iron Man? Okay, I'll choose Iron Man. Red or black? Red? Chocolate or strawberry? Chocolate? Okay, so we got Iron Man, red, and chocolate. So what are you going to do with these three answers that I've given you? Are you going to sum it up, and are you going to send me these three? Because I'll definitely love Iron Man in my studio right now. Not the man himself, I just want his suit, okay? But definitely. Next Facebook question is by Adele. How often do you work out at the gym? Oh, okay. So I work out. Okay, this is like a phase. When I feel like I should make my body, I should really pump my body up, I hit the gym pretty much like 5 times a week, and I do a series of like a. I don't train for that long, but I pump myself up for like 1 or 2 hours, and I just leave. Okay, I find it more efficient if you go and just really squeeze out all that energy, all the, I guess, strength that you have inside you, just to go a little bit further. I guess we call that the X factor. I think that a lot of people call it the X factor. In order to, I guess, really progress in the growth of your muscle, or I guess just losing weight, cardio. So I advise, you know, my advice for all of you guys out there, if you wanna like train, if you wanna get like big, buff, you really have to go the extra limit that you think you just can't do, but you have to do it. You have to squeeze it out. And that's what really gives you the extra boost and the extra effect that you get later on. So definitely, I hit the gym 5 times a week. I don't anymore, but I will definitely go back very soon. Now, thank you guys for all those questions. And of course, more questions coming in if you send those on Twitter at @rome_cclown. At SBS Pop Asia, or post on the SBS Pop Asian Facebook page. Now guys, it's like I said, it's time to listen to one of our songs. Oh my god, this is a very exciting song, and it's by Nonetheless of C-Clown. Wow, if you're in a club right now and you're listening to my radio, I suggest you just put on your earphones, right? And just ignore the music that's coming out in the club, and just put on the earphones right now. Yeah, just listen to me. Crank up the volume and listen to this song, okay? Because this song is C-Clown Justice on SBS Pop Asia. Wow.